Hello everyone, my name is Jitender Bafna. I am a senior MuleSoft architect. In this video, we will going to see what are different types of joins available in DataWave transformation. So basically there are three kind of joins available in DataWave transformation. So basically join, then left join and outer join. So join will always merge to array from left object and the right object, but it will only join the match object, no, match data in the object. So basically match ID in your object. Left join will always include all the data from left side and the match data from the right side on basis of some ID. Outer join will include all the matching data from left and right hand side, apart from that non-matching data from left and the right object. So we will going to see that. Okay, so basically let me move to a DataWave playground. So basically in DataWave playground you have to make sure, like for using the join, you have to import this array, import start from DW core array, and like I have like two objects, one is employee and one is department. In employee, if you see the payload, I have like four employees, and like employee one, like, you know, assigned to department ID one. So department ID, and I also I have a department three department, like 1, 2, 3, and like different department. So employee one is assigned with department one, employee two is assigned to department one, employee three is assigned to department two, whereas like, you know, employee four is assigned with department four. If you see, there is a no department 4 in department object. So let's see. So now I want, like, you know, only matching records from left and the right object. So in that case you can use a join directly. So before we move on to this, I will show you something else. So basically a join returns an array or array all the left item and merge by ID with any right item that exist. It take four parameter: left object, right object, left criteria and the right criteria. Same thing left join, as I mentioned, left join returns an array all the left item merge by the ID with the right items that meet the joining criteria. It again take the four parameter: left, right, left criteria and the right criteria. We will see that. Then comes to outer join. So joins two array by given ID criteria. Outer join returns the array with the left item merged by ID, the right item in the case where exist. It return right item that are not present in the left. Okay, so it return both left and right as well as the match items. Okay, so let me move to DataView editor. So I will use the join, and I want to pass the four parameter. The first parameter is employee, and the second parameter will be department. Okay, then the third we have to pass the criteria. So now I want to match on the basis of department ID. So this department ID is common, and department ID is the common in department object. So what I can do, I can declare one, like I will use the lambda expression, and I can instead of department I can say emp. okay, then I can say emp dot, I will copy this department ID common, I can say that department, then I can say dept dot control V, and I will close this. So now you can see, let analyze. So it join like matching object from matching items from left and the right objects. So employee one, like, you know, department ID one, department ID one. Okay, apart from that, see employee two, it's belong to department, you know, department ID one, department ID one. Then third, employee ID three, no, and employee ID three I haven't given the name, so I can give some name, Jackie or something like that. So if you see, it also like pick the like employee from left and the matching department from the right. If you see, employee 4 haven't come here, and there's a no entry for department 3 because so there's a no department ID with 4 exist in the department objects. That is why you cannot see it here. Okay, let me do one thing. Copy this. If I put comma and control V, and I can say 4. So you can see now like employee 4th employee is also there, because now it found the matching department ID in the department object. Let me remove this again. Okay, so that is the function or like that is what a join do. Now let me go with lab join. If I put lab join here, okay, in case of lab join, what will happen? It will pick all the matching record from right side, and like there are few record which doesn't match on the left side. It will be also in the output. Okay, so if you see, employee 1 have a matching department, employee 2 have a matching department, employee 3 have a matching department, but employee 4 doesn't have any matching department in the match in department object, but still it shown in the output. So that is what left join does for you basically. Okay, it also pick the non matching items from the left object. Now there is a no right join in the MuleSoft. Okay, now if you want, if you have a some condition, you want to pick, you know, like all like non matching department also, and but only matching employee, not non matching employee. So you want in the output non matching as well as a matching department and only matching employee. In that case, what you have to do? So there is a no right join. So what you can do, you can just reverse the objects parameters. So I can say department instead of employee, and I can change this equals to DEPT. DEPT EMP EMP. So now in this case you can see department ID. So employee 1 is belongs to department 1, department ID, the employee 2 is also belong to department 1, then department ID 2, employee, you know, 3 is belongs to department 2 physics. Then we don't have any department where there is no employee. So but still it's shown in the output because we are using the lab join and we want like non matching department also. So that is why we can see it in the output. So now let's see what does outer joins do. Let me reverse everything again, and even if you keep this fine, so let me do outer join. Okay, if you see the output, you got this is the matching department employee, this is the matching department and the employee from left and right object, this is the also matching department and the department and the employee. But if you see, this is non match from the department object, this is non match department, and also this is the non match employee from the employee object, right? That's why you can see both here. So in that case, what is happening, what is difference between lab join and this join? In this case, it will also pick the non match record from both the object. Okay, so let me reverse it. It will doesn't make any difference. This variable can be anything, so but I generally follow the proper naming convention, so it's easy to understand. So here the output will remain same again, like, you know, only what will happen now, employee will become on the left and department will become on the right, but output is almost same, like you are getting two non-match, you know, like records, two non-match items from left and the right objects. Okay, so basically as I discussed, like there are three kind of join, One is like join, like which only shows like matching record from the left object or matching items from the left object and the right object. Left join basically it will show the matching record from the right object or and non and all the records from the left object, okay, or all the items from the left object. Whereas in outer join it will show the matching matching record from left and the right object as well as the non-match items from the left and the right objects. Okay, so this is very useful. So it's a similar to SQL joins only. So basically it is very useful when you want to, you know, merge two arrays basically, you know, on some conditions. So this joins are very handy in the data weave transformation. So I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please click on the subscribe button and click on the like button. Thanks for watching.